sitting here who's an entrepreneur, Sandeep. And he is the reason he has given me all the Google links, my Google address. We're not supposed to tell the name, etc. But it's not GK Nayak 1957 or something like that. It's actually a proper address which has come thanks to him, and he has done that. So traditionally, you know, we are a risk averse culture. The Odisha culture is risk averse. You would always prefer to take up a job which gives you a steady stream of income rather than go into the world of risky business where failure is more likely than success. But fortunately today, I see some of our exam students, Deva Smith, I see him, I see many others who have worked for some time, then they have taken up startup, but their business actually is outside the state. It's not within the state, it's outside the state. So we are talking about the talent and their ability to create a product or an idea or a service and use that idea and service to create employment and make money in the process. I think slowly it is starting, but still, I think we are some way away from the culture where everybody says, I want to become an entrepreneur. It's a challenge to tell a student not to take up a job and become an entrepreneur, even if you have a good idea. But we are working towards it. And we are actually not good models, because we ourselves have taken up a job which gives us a steady income, and to advise somebody that don't go for steady income but go for entrepreneurship is not actually a good role model. So for startup, there are three things which are required. One is a business idea. The next one is money, funding that you require. And then you require a customer, a client who will buy your product and you will, you know, use that your product. So the business idea, it's your own idea. Maybe somebody mentors and maybe your friends, etc., they tell you. The funding part, Mr. Rath just now mentioned about one of the opportunities. But I think the biggest challenge often is getting your first client, getting your first fellow who will be willing to take the risk of using your product. So we were discussing in the government that can the government have a policy about encouraging and be the first client of a startup. If the idea is good enough and if it can be used within the government, they can be the first client and they will get rid of all this process of selecting a product by eliminating and putting turnover criteria, experience criteria, blah blah blah, only supporting the startup. So this is a thought that is going on in the government. It is not yet concretized, but a lot of us are pushing for this idea, and if it actually happens, the government of Odisha will be the first client of your product. Of course, the second one you have to compete and sell. It's not like you can't just sell based on the benign ideas of the government. Yeah. So this is what we are attempting to do. Hopefully this will work.
You are right, sir. Recently there was an announcement like Odisha government has come out reserve a capital of 100 crore rupees for the startup. There was a news.
Yeah, but that is giving free money to people. That is not what we are talking about. We are talking about government buying a solution or a product or an idea and using it within the government. Typically, we do all this, you know, tender this and that to select it. So startup will never qualify in a tendering process.
Okay.
They will be disqualified. Pre-qualifications will be thrown out of the window.
Right.